Hey everybody, how you doing out there? It's yours truly. Just want to talk about a whole bunch of things today. I want to talk about this Diana Krall DVD, or as they say, Blu-ray. She's done a lot of concerts. She's done one in Paris, one in Rio, and we're going to talk about these both things. She's a jazz pianist. I don't know if you can say that. We're going to talk about her in length. These are massive concerts that she's done. It's jazz music. It's not like rock and roll music. It's not like Guns N' Roses or Metallica, if you're wondering. It's jazz, slow jazz. I don't know what you call it. Slow jazz, maybe? I don't know. But great jazz. She has about 15 CDs under her name. Singer-songwriter. That's just how many albums she really got in her repertoire. 15 CDs up to this date. Included her Blu-rays. So she's a jazz pianist. Pianist, I don't know how you pronounce that. Jazz pianist. She was married to the guy who you may have known in the Live Aid concerts. The very first one, to be exact. I forget his name. His name escapes me at the moment. But I know what his face looks like. But he was the guy at the first Live Aid concert in 1985, if you remember that. And that's just ridiculous, folks. So we're gonna talk about Diana Krall in length, if that's okay with you guys out there. She plays a little piano. I don't know anything else besides that. People have to tell me. Put it in the comments, as they say, like YouTubers would say. Put it in the comment section, hit that like button, you know the deal. I won't say it millions of times. But yeah, just go try out her music. She's quite, I think she's Canadian. I think she's Canadian or America, I'm not too sure. But look it up on the Wikipedia page, and they'll tell everything about her. Where she lives, to residency, to how many children she has in the family, to... So give this girl a try. She's been around, she has 15 CDs in the world. This was in record stores. So, 15 CDs, this is not like your Guns N' Roses or Metallicas of the world. Big arenas, big massive arenas. Sell up big mass arenas. No, it's not like that. She's just a Canadian jazz, smooth jazz, I guess they call it smooth jazz. It's kind of like that. It's not like really fast up tempo jazz. It's a slow jazz, and people do like it. I'll put her name out there just to let you guys know what I'm talking about. She's been on two concerts as far as the Blu-rays are concerned. Live in Paris, live in Rio. So we're going to talk about these both concerts she's been in. She's Canadian, yes. I would think she was Canadian. There you go, Diana Krall. We're going to talk about her in length, if that's okay with you guys out there. She's married to that guy. I can't remember his name. Alex Kresko or something? I don't know. It's hard to pronounce. Somebody will have to tell me out there. There you go, folks. We'll be talking about her in length. 15 CDs to her name, and singer and songwriter, and a lot of CDs. She's done a lot of CDs. If you go look at her Wikipedia page, it'll tell her discography, as they would call it, discography. 15 CDs and counting, as they would say, to date. And she's married to that guy who, the first Live Aid concert, you may have heard about him on one of these concerts. I'm pretty sure I know what he looks like. But there you go, folks. I'll be mentioning that tonight. So here we go for us. We're talking about Diana Krall in length, or in depth, as they would say. Her Wikipedia page to her everything about her that makes her Diana Krall, makes her, what's in the name, what's in the product, what is in with the disc, and the sound quality. Just the CDs that she ever wrote. They were saying, remember, she's a singer-songwriter. She plays piano. She plays a little singing. So she's mostly singer-songwriter, as they would say on radio stations and TV stations. Singer-songwriter, that's her title, as Diana Krall, that she is. But look at her credits. Look at her credits in the albums. But yeah, she does a little piano stuff. It's like Gowan. It's like Larry Gowan. But you guys get the drift. But like I said, folks, she's a pianist, and as far as I know about her a bit, because I've seen her concerts and her performances. And yeah, just bear this in mind. You guys can go ask yourself, which is Diana Krall, ask her, besides playing piano, ask her what else instrument she likes to play. Just ask her nicely, because she is a woman, you know, folks. Yeah, just ask her straight out, does she play any else instruments besides piano? But she does smooth jazz, like very smooth. It's like driving in a smooth road, you know, it's like that, smooth jazz. And yeah, Diana Krall has been around 15 CDs to date, as far as I'm concerned. And she's married to that guy now. You may have seen him on the Live Aid concert in 1985. I forget his name. Caruso, I think his name was. But yeah, he has. I remember him in that first Live Aid concert. He was in there somewhere. But there you go, folks. I wanna go in depth. I'm gonna be interviewing Diana Krall, right, for the very first time, and so anxious about it. Remember, she's a woman. She plays piano, as far as a lot of people is concerned. Yeah, she's pretty good at it. I don't really think she's done any duels, duel performances with anybody else, but you'll have to ask her. But I think Bryan Adams, there was one singer that she may have sang with Bryan Adams. Maybe I could be wrong about this, but ask her, just flat out ask her nicely, what kind of a dual performance have you done? Just ask her nicely, Diana Krall, and maybe she'll answer it for you. But yeah, people sometimes do, when the albums like to do a dual song. And that sometimes helps, not always one singer singing it. It really helps out. So, folks, I'm going to talk about Diana Krall in depth. I'm going to put that in title, in depth, like an interview would say. You get a very interesting interview out of these people. You really do. They're just like you and I until we get in the interviews. First off and foremost, I want to appreciate the Diana Krall, the way she has presented herself in these albums, and the way they portray her in these albums. And she's got a Blu-ray disc. She was doing a live concert in Rio. Last one was in Paris. So you can tell that she's very high performance person. And we went to see her. She did a live performance in, I think, Union Station. That's here in Toronto. It was just a free concert, as they would say, as the word applies. They had almost, it was like a full orchestra. It was, I kid you not, it was almost a full orchestra, along with the... So there you go, folks. I want to talk about Diana Krall in depth. In her interview. Now, I don't know how her age is, but she's a great performer. She's in adult age. Yeah. So there you go, folks. Let's talk about her in depth. I'm not too crazy about her music selection, as they would say, music selection. But yeah, I like rock and roll, and she really likes jazz. It's a different genre. But music is supposed to be universal. Everybody would say music is universal. It's not just one type of genre. So there you go. You have rap, rock, what else? Blues music. You could have, I'll give you pretty much good examples. So I'm going to sound in stereo. This is a stereo podcast, in stereo sounding podcast. And... I want to give kudos where kudos is due, and if you want more details on Diana Krall, go look her up on Wikipedia, type her up on the Wikipedia page. You get everything you want to know about Diana Krall, the whole enchilada. Yeah. And, yeah, these are public people. These are public people. They're not private people. They're public people. They're out in the public doing what they need to do, you know, get a crowd going. And Diana Krall, she's made success. It's not just one CD she made, several of them. That's just, so she's accomplished a lot in her day. You know, she moved up the ranks. She moved up the ranks. Everybody got to know her. And people are taking her seriously enough. And she just does smooth jazz stuff. And the word applies, you know. Remember, music is universal. If you hear people say music is universal, it really is. That's what it means. It means universal. It means all genre across the board, as they would say, right? In any interview. It doesn't matter if it's rap, rock, heavy metal, doesn't matter what kind of music, it's got to be music, even classical music, even, it doesn't matter. Universal, if you hear people saying universal music, they really mean that. That means every genre that's out there. And, rap, rock, or screaming in the mic kind of music. Iron Maiden, if you're an Iron Maiden fan, that's heavy rock music. Just do what you have to do to be in stereo, not mono sounding. Just be in stereo. Promise me that, guys out there. Yeah. So make sure your microphones sound in stereo, not mono. So there you go, folks. I'm talking about Diana Krall in a great depth in an interview in stereo sounding right here on my podcast. Stay tuned for more after this commercial break. We'll be right back after this. Stay tuned. Don't touch the dial. Promise me that.